When it comes to data analysis, pivot tables or pivoting is a powerful data analysis tool. It is sometimes referred to as OLAP Cubes or online analytic processing. And basically what you can do with the OLAP is take a data set that has multiple dimensions and you can analyze the data on the fly. In our case, our target variable is evaluation. And we would like to estimate the average teaching evaluation and the corresponding standard deviation for age, for teaching evaluations, beauty, and age. But at the same time, we want to add further dimensions to it, such as gender, tenure, English language proficiency, and the visible minority status. And the two key statistics we are interested in are mean and standard deviation. So using the OLAP cubes, you can see that you can do the analysis on the fly. Let us repeat this analysis using SPSS. So in SPSS, we pick an analyze, reports, and then click on OLAP cubes. And then we select the summary variables that we are interested in, age, beauty score, and teaching evaluation. We select the four categorical variables as grouping variables. Within statistics, we select number of cases, mean, and standard deviation, and then press OK, and the output should appear in the output window. Here you go, you have the age, normalized beauty score, teaching evaluation, and the summary statistics for the three, and you could see that the results are similar as to one we obtained before. The primary advantage of using OLAP cubes or pivoting is the analytics on the fly, that it allows you to estimate the numbers using various choices, and I'll show you right now. If I were to double click on this table, it will open up the pivoting option, and we can even have a formatting bar that comes with it. So within the gender or female variable, let's say we select females who are not visible minority and who speak English as a native speaker and are tenured, and the numbers are changing accordingly. For untenured female professors who are not visible minority and speak English as native, the numbers are as follows. The average age is 49.8. And for tenured, 42.05. If they're not a native speaker of English language, you see the numbers change drastically. So the strength of OLAP cubes is that you can make selections right here and the numbers are updated in your table. And once you got the numbers that you like, you just click here and this is your output. The pivoting option is very interesting. Let's say we take the tenured variable and drag it and drop it here. And all of a sudden our table is updated here. You could see that now we have added a new dimension. And not only this, we can actually transpose our table. For transposing, I simply click the statistics, bring them here, and move these over here, variables and tenured status. And if I unselect or just go back to output, you could see that my results have been transposed. Let's say I'm interested in making a chart from this. So I can select, for example, mean value. What is the average age of tenured and untenured profs? I highlighted these two numbers, right clicked on it, and I said create a graph, and let's say create a bar chart from it. And right away I get the bar chart output with the non-tenured profs being slightly older than the tenured profs. So essentially, pivoting is analytics on the fly. You can create tables, you can manipulate the results, and at the same time, you can graph the or chart the relationships of interest. This way, you don't have to subset data, you don't have to write if-then statements. You simply manipulate data on the go and get the results there.